Father, we are grateful to you for this great and wonderful day.
Baba, tunakushukuru kwa siku hii kuu.
This is the day that you have made.
Yule ni siku ambayo umeitengeneza.
That you may rejoice and be glad in it.
Nitufurahie na kushangilia.
Lord, as your servant comes to minister this morning,
Baba, mtumishi wako anapokuja kuhudumu asubuhi,
we surrender him to you.
Tunamsalimisha kwako.
May he use me in a mighty way.
Tumie katika njia kuu.
Help us to understand the message.
Tusaidie kufahamu ujumbe.
In the name of Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu.
Thank you for those who are here.
Asante kwa wote.
And thank you for those who are coming.
Asante kwa wale wanao.
As we listen to this message together.
Na kusikiza ujumbe pamoja.
May you bless us.
Baba tubariki.
We honor you and appreciate you.
Na kuheshimu na
kukuabudu. We give you a clap offering of praises this morning. Shall we celebrate Jesus again this morning? Celebrate Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Just tell to somebody and tell them it's good to see you. Thank you for coming. Tell somebody it's good to see you. Thank you for coming. This is a wonderful day. In Jesus' name. Now I want us to ask together to welcome our Pastor Gitau to come and minister this morning in Jesus' name. Shall we appreciate God as he comes? To bring the word of God to us this morning. Let us appreciate Jesus as he comes.
Because of this opportunity to come and share the word of God with us. I do not take it for granted. I know it is by the grace of God. That is why this morning I'm persuaded to sing this song together. That it is by the grace of God. Ni kwa neema ya Mungu. Tuko hapa kwa sababu ya neema ya Mungu. There are many who have big plans.
Wengi wamekuwa na mioyo mikubwa.
But the grace of God is sufficient for us this morning.
Lakini neema ya Mungu imetutosha siku ya leo.
So praise and worship, please.
Wana ibada na
sifa kwa
dakika moja.
Neema ya Mungu. It is by the grace of God.
Ni kwa neema ya Mungu.
Mungu Baba ni mwema,
kubwa ni wa neema. Mungu Baba ni wa neema, kubwa
ni wa neema. Mungu Baba ni wa
Yeah.
That it is by your grace, our Father, that we are able to start this day, our Father. Jehovah, Lord, we give you all the glory. Jehovah, Lord, as you seek to listen to your word, I pray that, Jehovah, Lord, your grace shall be upon each and every one of us, our Father. That Jehovah, King of all glory, shall reach us in a way that you have not done before, our Father. Because this day, our Father, you made it, our Father, that we may gather here this day, O God, that we may hear of your counsel, my Father, because of your love and your grace, O God. Jehovah, we submit ourselves unto you, my Father. Jehovah, each and every one of us that is in this sanctuary, our Father. Lord, I pray, King of all glory, that you shall speak to them in a new way, our Father. That in a small, still voice, our Father, your word shall reach their hearts, O God. We glorify you, O God. We worship you, for you are God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Let us take our seats. Once again, I glorify the name of the Lord. Because of giving me this opportunity to study in our midst. And I want to remind you again that it is by the grace of God. This morning, I am happy to be in the midst of some very important ladies. It's very important to my life. Our mama is right here with us. Hallelujah. My wife is here with us. And my daughters are here with us. At least stand and wave. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's open our Bibles. In the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter number 32. 2 Chronicles 32. And we are reading verse 10. You are there, shout amen. Second Chronicles chapter number 32, verse number 10.
Mambo ya nyakati wa pili, 32 mstari wa 10.
Thus saith Sennacherib, king of Assyria.
Sennacherib, mfalme wa Ashuru.
Whereon do ye trust that you abide in the siege in Jerusalem?
Asema hivi, matumaini nini, matumainia nini, hata mkae suriwa katika Jerusalem.
Whereon do ye trust that you abide in siege in Jerusalem?
Matumainia nini, hata mkae mkihusuriwa katika Jerusalem.
The king of Assyria,
mfalme wa Ashuru,
was wondering.
Alikuwa kishanga.
How come?
Inawezekanaje?
That people are in Jerusalem.
Ya kwamba watu wako Yerusalemu.
And they are peaceful in Jerusalem.
Na wako na amani Yerusalemu.
And Jerusalem was under siege.
Na Yerusalemu ilikuwa katika umateka.
The people of Jerusalem.
Watu wa Yerusalem,
under the king Hezekiah,
chini ya mfalme Hezekiah,
they were abiding in Jerusalem.
Walikuwa wameketi Yerusalem,
and Jerusalem,
na Yerusalem,
was under siege.
Ilikuwa chini ya umateka.
We are told in the passage.
Tunaambiwa katika maandiko.
We are going to be looking at several verses of this passage.
Tutakuwa tukitazamia mistari kadhaa katika maandiko.
That the king of Assyria,
ya kwamba mfalme wa
had conquered the other 10 cities. And now he had focused his eyes on conquering Jerusalem. Seeing that he has conquered the rest. Now his eyes were focused on conquering Jerusalem. So he encamped around outside Jerusalem. And he sent some emissary. Akatuma watu wa kwenda ndani ya Jerusalem. Ili waende wakapeleke habari fulani ndani ya Yerusalem. So when he sent the emissary into Jerusalem,
wakati alituma uchuke kule Yerusalem,
then he asked King Hezekiah,
akamuuliza mfalme,
and the people of Jerusalem,
na watu wa Yerusalem,
how come you are abiding in Jerusalem? And Jerusalem is under siege. How come you are staying in this place? And this place has already been surrounded. In other words, he was asking, what is this that makes you stay in Jerusalem? When there is trouble in Jerusalem, the king of Assyria had a lot of confidence in himself. Seeing how he had captured all the other cities. Seeing how he had destroyed all the other cities. And now he had come to Jerusalem. So the title of my message today is on what basis is your confidence? On what basis is your confidence?
Ujasiri wako uko juu ya nini?
The New International Version.
Katika Biblia mpya.
The New International Version of the Bible says, verse 10, on what are you basing your confidence?
Ujasiri wako uko juu ya nini?
The king of Assyria was asking King Hezekiah and his people, on what are you basing your confidence on? King Hezekiah did not have the might of the armies as the king of Assyria. And when the king Hezekiah heard of the coming of the king of Assyria, he was terrified. And this is what he did. He fortified the city. He repaired the wall that was broken. He even went ahead to build another wall to make sure that the city is
safe.
He even bought more armor. He prepared for war because he was terrified. He was terrified of the king of Assyria and the army that was with him. So, King Hezekiah, being worried of the conquest of Jerusalem,
prepared.
He was scared. He knew that he was not a match to the king of Assyria. But there is something that King Hezekiah knew.
Lakini kuna kitu ambao mfalme Hezekiah alijua.
Which the king of Assyria did not know.
Ambacho mfalme wa Ashuru hakujua.
And the Bible says, we're going to read verse 5.
Tutasoma mstari wa 5.
Of the same chapter. Also, he strengthened himself, built up all the wall that was broken, and raised it up to the towers, and another wall without, and repaired Milo in the city of David, and made that and shield in Abadans.
Akapita moyo konde, akaujenga ukuta wote uliobomoka akainua sawa na minara ya ukuta wa pili nje akaongeza nguvu ya Milo katikati ya mji wa Daudi akafanya silaha na ngao tele.
Verse number 6.
Mstari wa sita.
And he set captains of war over the people and gathered them together to him in the streets of the gates of the city and spake comfortably to them saying.
Akaweka makida wa vita juu ya watu, akawakusanya wake uandani penye lango la mji, akawafurahisha mioyo akisema,
be strong and courageous.
Iweni hodari na wa moyo mkuu.
Be not afraid.
Msiogope.
Nor dismayed.
Wala msifadhaike.
For the king of Assyria.
Kwa sababu mfalme wa Ashuru.
Nor for the multitudes is with him.
Wala kwa majeshi yote walio pamoja naye.
For there is more with us
than with them. Kwa maana yupo mkuu pamoja nasi kuliko aliye pamoja nao.
So King Hezekiah.
Kwa hivyo mfalme Hezekiah
knew something that was not obvious to the king of Assyria.
Alijua kitu ambacho kikuwa cha kawaida kwa mfalme wa Ashuru.
The Bible says that the king of Assyria had multitudes of soldiers.
Biblia nasema mfalme wa Ashuru alikuwa na jeshi kuu.
He could trust on the numbers.
Angeweza kutumainia hiyo hesabu.
He could trust on the experience of conquering the other 10 cities.
Angeweza kuhesabia ule ujuzi alitumia kushinda ile miji.
But King Hezekiah.
Lakini mfalme Hezekiah.
Did not have this advantage.
Hakukuwa na fursa hiyo.
But Hezekiah knew.
Lakini Hezekiah alijua.
That the ones that are with him.
Ya kwamba wale walio na yeye.
Are more.
Ni wengi.
Than the ones that are with the king of Assyria.
Kuliko wale walio na mfalme wa Ashuru.
The same verse that Pastor Tobias has read.
Mstari ambao mchungaji Tobias amesoma.
Concerning Elisha.
Kuhusu Elisha.
And the prayer that Elisha made.
Na ombi ambalo Elisha alifanya.
That the eyes of his servant be open.
Ya kwamba macho ya mtumishi wake.
That he might see the multitude of chariots.
Akaweza kuona umati
wa magari. That were with them on the mountain.
Waliokuwa pamoja naye pale mlimani.
Versus what was the soldiers that we are fearing.
Kama vile yani zaidi kuliko wale majeshi ambao tumeogopa.
So what is this confidence?
Je, ujasiri wake ni upi?
This is what the Bible says.
Biblia inasema hivi.
The speaking of the king Hezekiah.
Kunena kwa mfalme Hezekiah.
With him.
Pamoja naye.
The king of Assyria.
Na mfalme wa Ashuru.
With him.
Naye mfalme.
Is an army of flesh.
Yeye ako na jeshi la kimwili.
But with us.
Lakini sisi.
And to fight our battles.
Na kupigana vita vyetu.
Sorry. With us is the Lord our God.
Lakini upande wetu tunaye Bwana Mungu.
To help us.
Wa kutusaidia.
And to fight our battles.
Na kupigana vita vyetu.
The king of Assyria depended on his armies, his numbers and his experience.
Mfalme wa Ashuru alitegemea jeshi lake hesabu yake.
But King Hezekiah depended not on his armies.
Lakini mfalme Hezekiah hakutegemea jeshi lake.
He spoke to his soldiers.
Aliwanenea watu wake.
He spoke to his people.
Alinenea watu wake.
Encourage them.
Na kuwatia moyo.
And to let them see.
Na kuwasababisha waone.
And to give them the courage.
Na kuwapa tumaini.
Because there is something that he saw.
Kwa sababu kuna kitu waliona.
That the Lord is with them.
Ya kwamba Bwana yupo pamoja nao.
And that Lord that was with them.
Na huyo Bwana aliyekuwa pamoja nao.
Was with them to fight for them.
Alikuwa nao awapiganie.
So he was not terrified.
Kwa hivyo hakuwa na hofu.
For he prepared for war.
Alikwanza alijiandaa kwa
ajili ya. He was not terrified.
Hakuwa na hofu.
Because his confidence was not in the flesh.
Maana tumaini lake halikuwa
kwenye. But his confidence was on the Lord God.
Lakini tumaini lake lilikuwa katika Bwana Mungu.
This is the same story.
Hivi ndivyo hadithi ya mfalme.
That we are told of David.
Tunaambiwa kuhusu Daudi.
We know of the story of David.
Tunajua hadithi ya Daudi.
When he went to fight Goliath.
Alipoenda kupigana na Goliath.
When he had the mocking of the children of God by the Philistine.
Aliposikia kule kukejeliwa kwa wana wa Mungu na
Wafilisti. He was worked up.
Aliweza kuchochewa.
And he was asking himself.
Na alikuwa anajiuliza.
How come the people of God?
Je, itakuwaje watu wa Mungu?
They are being mocked.
Wanakejeliwa.
In fact, he did not look at it like the people of God were being mocked. But he looked at it like the God that he believed in was being mocked.
Hakuona kwamba watu wa Mungu walikuwa wanakejeliwa, lakini aliona yule Mungu
anayemwambia how to go and fight the Philistines.
Akaamua kwenda kupigana na Wafilisti.
But I want us to look at something very carefully.
Nataka tuangalie kitu kwa umakini.
You know when he was taken before Saul.
Unajua wakati alichukuliwa mbele ya Sauli.
He inherited to Saul.
Aliweza kumtolea Sauli hadithi.
And he told Saul, "What I was keeping my father's goats."
Akamwambia wakati nilikuwa nachunga mbuzi.
A lion arose.
Simba alitokea.
And I teared the lion into pieces.
Na nikamrarua katika vipande vipande.
And that is not enough.
Na hiyo haijatosha.
Even a bear came.
Hata dubu akatokea.
And I eat the same.
Na nikafanya vile.
So David also had some experience of war.
Kwa hivyo Daudi pia alikuwa na ule ujuzi wa vita.
I want to thank God.
Lakini nataka nimshukuru Mungu.
Because even with that kind of experience.
Kwa hata na huo ujuzi.
Even with that kind of courage.
Hata na huo ujasiri.
David did not choose to focus on himself.
Daudi hakuchukua kujichunguza kujichunguza mwenyewe.
He chose to focus on the Lord.
Alichagua kumtazamia Bwana.
Let's look at that verse. Huh?
Tuangalie huo mstari.
That is in the book of 1 Samuel.
Samueli wa kwanza.
So 1 Samuel chapter number 17.
Samueli wa kwanza 17.
Verse number 34 is what I'm talking about. Saul, the explanation that David about killing the lion and the bear.
Inanenea mstari wa 34 kuhusu Daudi alipouwa simba.
And when we look at verse number 37, that's my focus.
Ukiangalia mstari wa 37, hapo ndio mtazamio wangu.
David.
Daudi.
This is what he said.
Hivi ndivyo alivyosema.
The Lord that delivered me out of the paws of the lion and out of the paws of the bear, he will deliver me out of the hands of this Philistine.
Daudi akasema, Bwana aliyeniokoa na makucha ya simba na makucha ya dubu ataniokoa na mkono wa Mfilisti huyu.
So what are we saying?
Tunasema nini?
That David did not focus on his experience and his courage and his bravery.
Ya kwamba Daudi hakutazamia uwerevu wake na
ujasiri. But he focused on the Lord.
Lakini alitazamia
the same Lord that delivered me out of the paws of the lion.
Bwana aliyeniokoa kutoka katika
out of the paws of the bear.
Kutoka kwenye makucha ya dubu.
He will deliver me.
Ataniokoa.
From the hands of this Philistine.
Kutoka katika mikono ya huyo Mfilisti.
And therefore.
Na kwa hivyo.
David courageously moved forward.
Daudi kwa ujasiri akasonga mbele.
And this story, I like this story.
Napenda sana hadithi hii.
Because King Saul.
Kwa sababu mfalme Sauli
himself did not understand this kind of courage, did not understand this kind of trust that this boy had.
Yeye mwenyewe hakuelewa ujasiri huu na hata tumaini ambalo huyu kijana alikuwa nalo.
He knew that when you are going to war, you need some sword, you need some armor.
Alijua kwamba unapoenda kwenye vita unahitaji mikuki, unahitaji mishale.
He took his armor and gave it to this boy.
Akachukua mishale yake akampatia huyu kijana.
But David.
Lakini Daudi.
Fitted those clothes.
Aliweza kupalia yale mavazi.
And he found himself uncomfortable.
Akajikuta hana ule wepesi.
And he put them down and said,
akatoa hayo mavazi.
I am not used to this.
Mimi sijazoea haya.
I am not used to trusting on armor.
Sijazoea kutegemea.
I am not used to trusting on myself.
Sijategemea kujitegemea.
I'm used to depending on Jesus.
Nimezoea kumtegemea.
I'm used to depending on God.
Nimezoea kumtegemea Mungu.
Because though I fought the lion.
Kwa sababu wakati nilipigana na simba.
Though I fought the bear.
Hata nilipopigana na dubu.
In fact, the Bible did not say that he fought. The Bible says he teared.
Biblia inasema hakupigana bali alirarua.
There is a difference between fighting and being beaten.
Kuna utofauti wa kupigana na kupigwa.
Yeah, even in a football match.
Hata katika ule mchezo wa kandanda.
When you go to a match and you are given 1-1, you say we fought.
Ukienda ule mchezo mwenye safari ya kwanza unasema mlipigana.
Lakini if you go to a match and you are beaten 7-0.
Ukienda kwenye mchezo mpigwe 7-0.
You say you are beaten.
Mnasema mlipigwa.
So we are saying,
kwa hivyo tunasema
that David actually deared the bear.
Ya kwamba Daudi alimrarua dubu.
It doesn't look like he struggled with the bear.
Haionekani kwamba aling'ang'ana na huyo.
And he says this.
Na akasema hivi.
That it is the Lord.
Ya kwamba ni Bwana.
That made me dear the bear.
Aliyenisababisha nimrarue.
And this same God.
Na huyo huyo Mungu.
Is going to deliver me from the Philistine.
Atanikomboa kutoka katika mikono ya Mfilisti.
The Bible says.
Biblia inasema.
In Psalms.
Zaburi.
Chapter number 20.
Zaburi 20.
And verse number 7.
Mstari wa 7.
Psalms 20, verse 7.
Zaburi 20, mstari wa 7.
In the same David.
Daudi huyo mmoja.
Anasema, some trust in chariots.
Hawa wanataja magari.
And some in hosts.
Na hawa mafarasi.
But we will remember the name of the Lord our God.
Bali sisi tualitaja jina la Bwana Mungu wetu.
Some have chariots.
Hawa wanataja magari.
Some have horses.
Na hawa mafarasi.
Chariots will take you faster.
Magari yatakupeleka mbio.
Horses will take you further.
Farasi zitakupeleka zaidi.
But we will trust in the name of the Lord.
Bali sisi tutalitaja jina la Bwana Mungu wetu.
This is the confidence that we have.
Huu ndio ujasiri tulio nao.
That it is not in the chariots.
Ya kwamba sio kwa magari.
It is not in the horses.
Ya kwamba sio kwa mafarasi.
But it is in the name of the Lord.
Bali ni kwa jina la Mungu.
And I can confirm to you this day.
Na naweza kukuonyesha leo kwamba
that you can have the chariots.
Ya kwamba uenda ukawa na
you can have the horses.
Unaweza kuwa na hayo magari.
But when you have the name of the Lord.
Lakini kama uko na jina la Bwana.
You will go far.
Utaenda zaidi.
You will go faster.
Utaenda kwa wepesi.
I remember the incidents of Elijah.
Nakumbuka wakati wa Elijah.
When they were on the mountain with Ahab.
Walipokuwa kwenye mlima na Ahab.
When they looked and saw the crowd of the crowd coming.
Walipotazamia
mvua. A sign that rain was just about to start falling.
Ishara ya kuonyesha mvua inakaribia kuanza.
What did Ahab do?
Ahab alifanya nini?
He sat on the horse.
Aliketi kwenye farasi.
And he ran.
Na akakimbia.
And Elijah.
Na Elijah.
Who did not want to sit on the horse.
Ambao hakutaka kuketi kwenye farasi.
He glided through.
Yeye alipita katikati.
He ran and he overtook the horse.
Alikimbia na akashinda hata yule farasi.
Why?
Kwa nini?
Because Ahab would trust on the horses.
Kwa sababu Ahab aliweza kutumainia farasi.
Ahab had the chariots to trust on.
Ahab alikuwa na magari yote angetumainia.
But Elijah.
Lakini Elijah.
Had the name of the Lord.
Alikuwa na jina la Bwana.
The name of the Lord.
Jina la Bwana.
The Bible says is a strong tower.
Biblia inasema ni ngome imara.
And the righteous ran unto it.
Na wenye haki ulikimbia.
And they are safe.
Wakawa salama.
This is the same name that I'm calling upon this day.
Hili ndilo jina na lile.
This is the same message that I'm giving to us today.
Ndio ujumbe na wapeni leo.
We if we trust in the name of the Lord.
Tukapo tumainia jina la Bwana.
We shall do exploits.
Tutafanya makuu.
We shall do things that will surprise the world.
Tutafanya vitu ambavyo vita
It is not by connections. Promotion does not come from connections. If you depend on Godfathers, let me tell you this morning that Godfathers will fade away. They are also human beings, and they are also depending on God. It is not in our might. It is not in our numbers. Like the king of Assyria, him, he could look at the armies that were with him. And that is why he was able to focus his eyes on conquering Jerusalem. Because he saw the numbers that he was having. But Hezekiah, who did not have the numbers,
who
only looked up and said, Jehovah, you are my strength. It is you who is going to fight this battle for me. It is you who is going to grant me this victory. In your business, in your career, in your family. Your victory is not coming from your wisdom. It is not from your understanding. Because your understanding is limited. Because your understanding will fail. But if you trust on the knowledge of God, if you trust on the word of God, the Lord shall deliver you. The Lord shall give you victory. The Lord shall uplift you. Because the Lord does not uplift because of chariots. The Lord does not require the chariots to uplift you. Chariots are good. But I tell you, they are not dependable. It is good to have the chariots. But it is better to know that the name of the Lord is a better chariot. It is good to have connections. But it is good to know the connection with the Lord is a better connection. Where is your confidence? Is your confidence based on your position? Positions will fade away. Is your confidence in the knowledge of the leadership? Is it based on the fact that you are the brother to the sister or the uncle of the president? No. After 5 years, we elect another president. So your connection will be useless. But if you trust on the name of the Lord, you shall go far. The king of Assyria did not know this secret. The king Hezekiah knew where to depend, who to depend on.
Wapi pa kutegemea na ni nani wa kutegemewa?
Is your confidence in your knowledge?
Je, ujasiri wako uko katika hekima yako?
Is it based on your experience?
Iko katika ule ujuzi wako?
I want to remind you.
Nataka ni wakumbusheni.
That your knowledge and your experience is nothing before God. Actually, the word of God tells us in 1 Corinthians
1:25
that the foolishness of God is far above the wisdom of man.
Ni zaidi ya hekima ya mwanadamu.
The knowledge of man is so limited.
Ufahamu wa mwanadamu una kipimo.
Because while the Lord God
wakati Bwana Mungu
sees the end from the beginning,
anaona mwanzo hadi mwisho,
we do not have that privilege.
Hatutakuwa na ile fursa.
We only see what the circumstances that are around us.
Tunaona tu juu ya yale mazingira ambayo yako katikati yametuzunguka.
But it is the Lord that sees the end from the beginning.
Lakini ni Mungu anayeona mwanzo hadi mwisho.
So he is the Lord that is all knowledgeable.
Yeye ni Mungu ambao anajua yote.
So if we trust on the Lord,
tunapomtumainia Bwana,
who is all knowing,
yeye ambao amejua yote,
who is all knowledgeable,
yeye ambao anafahamu wote,
then we need not be worried.
Kwa hivyo hatupaswi kuwa na hofu.
In fact,
kwa hakika,
if we depend on God,
tunapomtegemea Mungu,
the Bible tells us that he has good plans over our lives.
Biblia inasema ana mipango mizuri juu ya maisha yetu.
So we only need to depend on him.
Tunahitaji tu kumtegemea.
Because he has good plans.
Kwa maana ana mipango mizuri.
But because of our limited knowledge,
lakini kwa sababu ya kile kipimo
cha maisha yetu, we fail to put our confidence in the name of the Lord.
Tunashindwa kuweka ujasiri wetu katika jina la Mungu.
And we start putting our confidence on perishable things.
Na tunaanza kuweka tumaini letu kwa vitu ambavyo vinaisha.
Our trust is in the name of the Lord.
Tumaini letu liko katika jina la Bwana.
If our trust is in the name of the Lord,
kama tumaini letu liko katika jina la Bwana,
then we can afford to smile.
Tunaweza kutabasamu.
And say,
tukisema,
that with God,
ya kwamba kwake Mungu,
everything is possible.
Kila kitu kinawezekana.
Because our God is the all-knowing God.
Ya kwamba Mungu wetu ni Mungu wa kipekee.
Proverbs 3 verse 5 and 6.
Methali 3 mstari wa 5 na 6.
Proverbs 3 verse 5.
Methali 3.
Trust in the Lord with all thine heart.
Tumaini Bwana kwa moyo wako wote.
And lean not on your own understanding.
Wala usizitegemee akili zako mwenyewe.
Trust the Lord with all your heart.
And
lean not on your own understanding.
Mtumaini Bwana kwa moyo wako wote, wala usizitegemee akili zako mwenyewe.
Why? Because our own understanding only speaks of the things that we have experience of.
Kwa nini? Kwa sababu akili zetu zinawaza tu juu ya vile vitu ambavyo tumeona.
Things that we have experienced or things that we have learned.
Vitu ambavyo tumejifunza ama tumeweza kusikia.
But it is only God who has the full understanding.
Ni Mungu tu aliye na ule ufahamu kamili.
So what does the Bible advise us to do?
Biblia inatuhimiza kufanya nini?
Trust in the Lord.
Tumainie Bwana.
Don't lean on your own understanding.
Wala usizitegemee akili zako
mwenyewe.
Mstari wa 6.
In all thy ways,
katika njia zako zote,
acknowledge him,
mkiri yeye,
and he shall direct thy paths.
Naye atayanyosha mapito yako.
So the Bible is saying,
kwa hivyo Biblia inasema,
that replace your trust in yourself.
Ukiweka tumaini lako ndani mwako.
Replace your confidence in yourself.
Weka ujasiri wako ndani mwako.
To the confidence in the name of the Lord.
Katika ujasiri wake Bwana.
And the only way you can have confidence in the name of the Lord.
Njia pekee ya kuwa na ujasiri katika jina la Bwana ni kwamba
if you acknowledge him.
Kama utamkiri
that you come to a level whereby you know, you understand that it is the Lord who fights your battle.
Unakuja katika kiwango cha kujua na kuelewa kwamba Bwana ndiye anayepigana vita vyako.
That is how to depend on God.
Hivyo ndivyo unaweza kumtegemea Mungu.
That is how to put your confidence in the Lord.
Hivyo ndivyo unaweza kuweka ujasiri wako kwa Mungu.
Because them that put their trust in the Lord,
na kwamba wale wanaoweka tumaini lao kwa Bwana,
they shall never be dismayed.
Hawataweza kushushwa.
They shall never be disappointed.
Hawataweza kushushwa.
Though the circumstances may be speaking otherwise,
licha ya hali zote zinaweza
kufanya, the Lord is able.
Bwana anaweza
to do exceedingly
kufanya zaidi
above what we ask, even what we imagine. Even when we are imagining defeats, our Lord is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above what we think and what we imagine. Because our imaginations are limited to our experience, and our God is not dependent on our experience.
Na Mungu wetu hategemei ujuzi wetu.
As high as heaven is,
jinsi vile mbingu zilivyo juu,
from the earth,
kutoka duniani,
so is the ways of the Lord,
ndipo njia zake Bwana,
from our ways,
kutoka katika njia zetu.
That is Isaiah 55 verse 8 and 9.
Isaiah 55 mstari wa 8 na 9.
Yes, we can trust, we can depend on the Lord, because we have this confidence that his ways are as high as the heavens are from our ways.
Tunaweza kuwa na tumaini hili katika Bwana kwamba njia zake ni
His knowledge is as high as the heavens.
Maarifa yake yako juu zaidi kama vile mbingu,
compared to what the earth is.
Kulinganishwa na vile ardhi ilivyo.
So as I finish,
kwa hivyo ninapotamatisha,
I'm asking you,
na kuuliza,
where is your confidence?
Ujasiri wako uko wapi?
Where is your confidence?
Ujasiri wako uko wapi?
Is it based on your experience?
Je, umesimama juu ya ujuzi wako?
Or is it based on the word of God?
Ama umesimamia juu ya neno la Mungu?
This is the call for this morning. That in all our things, let us acknowledge God. Because he is the source of our strength. He is the source of our victory. And in all things, when we acknowledge him,
na kwa hivyo kwa mambo yote tunapomtambua,
his favor will always be upon us.
Kibali chake kitakuwa juu yetu.
And victory will be ours.
Na ushindi utakuwa wetu.
So my brothers and sisters,
kwa hivyo ndugu zangu na dada zangu,
trust in the name of the Lord.
Tumainia jina la Bwana.
And you shall not be disappointed.
Nawe utaweza kuona mambo makuu.
Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus,
Baba wetu wa mbinguni katika jina la Yesu,
we submit unto you this morning.
Tunanyenyekea kwako asubuhi ya leo.
How we pray our Father.
Jinsi tunavyoomba e Mungu wetu.
That you may teach our hearts to depend on you, O God.
Mambo kafunze leo yetu kukutegemea Mungu.
Jehovah Lord, your word has told us, O God.
Jehovah Mungu neno lako limetuambia.
That you.
Ya kwamba wewe.
Are dependable.
Ni wa kutegemewa.
You are the solid rock.
When Mungu wa kipekee.
When we stand on you, our Father.
Tunaposimama kwako e Mungu wetu.
Our lives are secure.
Maisha yetu yako salama.
Our victory is sure.
Ushindi wetu ni wa hakika.
Jehovah, we worship you.
Jehovah, tunakuabudu.
In Jesus' name.
Katika jina la Yesu.
Amen.
Amen.
I thank you for your word. We receive it with thanksgiving and appreciation. Just open your mouth and tell God, I thank you for this word. I receive it with thanksgiving and with appreciation. Just tell him, I thank you. I thank you. I receive this message with thanksgiving and appreciation. Lord, I thank you for this message. I receive it as my message with thanksgiving and appreciation. I receive it from an individual perspective. This is my message. I receive it with thanksgiving. I appreciate you for your word. I thank you for this word. I thank you, my Father. I bless your name. I want us to confess that our God, my confidence is in you. Before we confess that, if you are here and you are not born again, this is your message. If you are not born again,
kama hujaokoka,
it means your confidence is not in God.
Inamaanisha kwamba tumaini lako haliko kwa Mungu.
Your confidence is not in Jesus Christ.
Tumaini lako haliko kwa Yesu Kristo.
There is a possibility,
kuna uwezekano,
that your confidence is in man.
Tumaini lako liko kwa mwanadamu.
Your confidence could be in other things that the man of God has mentioned.
Tumaini lako linaweza kwa vitu vingine ambavyo mtumishi wa Mungu
amezitaja. It could be in your experience.
Inaweza kuwa ni kwa tajiri
bala. It could be in your career.
Inaweza kuwa ni kwa kazi yako.
It could be in your chariots and horses.
Inaweza kuwa ni kwa magari na mafarasi.
Meaning your wealth.
Nataka kwa utajiri wako.
And so this morning I want to give you an opportunity.
Asubuhi ya leo nataka kukupa fursa.
To surrender your life to Jesus Christ.
Kukabidhi maisha yako kwa Yesu Kristo.
And put your confidence in him.
Na uweke tumaini lako kwake.
The way Ezekiel put his confidence in the Lord.
Jinsi vile Ezekiel aliweka tumaini lake kwa Mungu.
You are here, you are not born again, you want to receive Christ, lift up your hands, you pray to God.
Baba ukiokoka unataka kumpatia maisha yako Yesu Kristo.
We give you a chance to give your life to Christ.
Kupatia fursa ya kupeana maisha yako kwa Yesu.
And put your confidence in God.
Na kuweka tumaini lako kwa Mungu.
As we do like this, we are doing the great commission.
Na kufanya hivi tunafanya kazi kuu.
If you are there, you are not born again, lift up your hands, you pray together.
Kama hujaokoka inua mkono wako.
Amen. We are all born again. Shall we celebrate Jesus? Let us rise on our feet. We will make two prayers from what the man of God has shared. The first thing we are saying, we are telling God, my confidence is in you. Let him hear us confess.
Wacha asikie tukikiri
that our confidence is in him.
Ya kwamba tumaini letu li kwake.
It is not in our tall relatives.
Sio ni kwa wale marafiki watu wetu wa ukoo wa mbali.
It's not in the government of Kenya.
Sio kwamba kwa serikali ya Kenya.
In fact, if you put your confidence in the government of Kenya, you'll be disappointed greatly.
Kiweka tumaini lako kwa serikali ya Kenya itakuwa.
Let us tell God our confidence is in you.
Wacha tuambie Bwana tumaini letu liko.
Let's lift up your hands and open your mouth and tell him, Father, I confess this morning, my confidence is in you. My confidence as an individual. My Father, my confidence as an individual
is
in you. Lord, my confidence as an individual. My confidence is in you. In the name of Jesus, my confidence as an individual is in you. Our confidence as a church is in you. Our confidence as Dominion Worship Church, our confidence is in you. As Dominion Worship Church, our confidence is in you. My Father, my confidence is in you as an individual. My confidence is in you. My Father, my confidence is in you. My God, my confidence is in you. We have no confidence in chariots. We have no confidence in horses. Our confidence is in you. As a church of dominion, our confidence is in you. My Father, as an individual, my confidence is in you. 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 My Father, my confidence is in you. My God, my confidence is in you. My Father, my confidence is in you. In the name of Jesus, my confidence is in you. My confidence is in you, O Lord. My confidence is in you, O Lord. My confidence is in you. In the name of Jesus, as the Dominion Worship Church, we are confessing this morning. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. I want us to confess on behalf of Dominion Worship Church. Let us tell God our confidence is in you. We have no confidence in horses or chariots. Our confidence is in your name. Lift up your voice and tell God, as a church, our confidence is in you. Lord, as Dominion Worship Church, we confess this morning, our confidence is in you, O Lord. Our confidence is in you. Our confidence is in you. As a church, my Father, our confidence is in you. Our confidence is not in chariots. It's not in the multitude. Our confidence is not in the multitude. Our confidence is in you. As a family of Dominion Worship Church, Our confidence is in you, O Lord. Our confidence is in you. As a family of Dominion Lutheran Church, my Father, we confess on this day, the 18th day of April 2021, our confidence is in you, in the name of Jesus. Our confidence is in you. 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 In the name of Jesus. Thank you, our Father. Our confidence is in you as a church. Our confidence is in you. In the name of Jesus. Our confidence is in you. In the name of Jesus. Our Father, our confidence is in you. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. One of the ways of showing our confidence in the Lord is to hand him our battles to fight for us. By handing him our battles, we are telling the Lord our confidence is not in our experience of warfare. It's not in our experience of fighting. It's not in our artillery or our weapons. It is not in our bravery. We are telling him that our confidence is in you. Where the servant of God has read 2 Chronicles chapter 32 verse 8.
2 Chronicles Mambo ya Nyakati wa pili 32 mstari wa 8.
The Bible says,
Biblia inasema,
he may have a great army, but they are just men. We have the Lord our God to help us and to fight our battles for us. These words greatly encouraged the people. Is somebody getting encouraged by these words? The Bible says these words greatly encouraged the people. Is somebody getting encouraged by these words? And so we are going to tell God this morning as a way of showing our confidence in him. We are telling him, Lord, help us and fight our battles for us. Is there somebody having battles in his life? Do I have a witness? Are you having some battles around you? Lift up your hand. I have many battles. I believe you have several. I want us to tell the Lord, Father, help me and fight my battles for me. That is what David did in 1 Samuel chapter 17. In verse 47, David says that the battle belongs to the Lord. The battle is the Lord's. 47. And all this assembly shall know that the Lord serveth not with sword and spear. For the battle is the Lord's, and he will give you Goliath into our hands. Let us go before God and tell him, Father, help me and fight this battle for me. That battle you are having in your life, when you hand it over to God, there is no doubt that you will have victory. Victory is assured. Lift up your right hand. Say, my Father, my Father. Lift up your voice. Say, my Father, my Father. In the name of Jesus, I surrender these battles to you. The battles in my life, the battles at my place of work, the battles in my business, the battles in my family, the battles in my ministry. Oh God, I pray, fight these battles for me. Fight these battles for me. Begin to pray in Jesus' name. Father, I pray that you fight these battles for me, the battles of my family, the battles of my place of work, the battles of my business, the battles of my spiritual life, the battles of my career. I call it the spiritual battles. I call it my life. I call it my family. I call it my children. My Father, I pray, fight these battles for me. Fight these battles for me. Every battle that is rising up, I call it my life. I call it my children. I call it my family. Every battle rising up, I call it my children. I call it my family. I call it my neighbors. My Father, I pray, fight these battles for me. Fight these battles for me. This battle belongs to you. This battle belongs to you. The battles rising up from Goliath. The battles rising up from Goliath. I can use my ministry. I can use my calling. I can use my career. I can use my salvation. The battles rising up. I can use my life. I can use my family. Father, I pray. Fight these battles for me. 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 In the name of Jesus, I cover every battle that I'm facing in my life. I pray in Jesus' name. Every battle I am facing as an individual. Every battle my wife is facing. Every battle my children are facing. Every battle we are facing as a family. From Goliath, from the enemy, from the king of Assyria. From Goliath, from the king of Assyria. My God, I pray, fight for me. 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 These battles are rising up against me. From Goliath, from the king of Assyria. Spiritual battles from the village, from the town. The battles rising up. I can use my family. I can use my career. I can use my staff. These battles from Goliath, from Assyria. My Father, fight for me. Fight these battles for me. Fight these battles for me. Fight these battles for me. In the name of Jesus, fight these battles for me. In the name of Jesus, fight these battles for me. In the name of Jesus, fight these battles for me. 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 In the name of Jesus, make yourself a tabaga. Let my tabaga say, no my tabaga. Fight these battles for me. 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 In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. If you are there and you are facing some serious battle in your life, just come. You are having some Goliath raising up serious battles. Just come immediately. There is some king of Assyria raising up serious battles against your life. Just come. We want to just go together with you. That he will fight for you. That will help you. Just keep social distance around this place. As we go to pray, some can stand behind the others, but try to keep social distancing. In the name of Jesus, just lift up your hands as we go to pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, behold, these are your sons and daughters that are going through battles of life. There are some battles from Goliath that have risen up against their lives. There are some battles from the king of Assyria that have risen up against their lives. Battles in their families, battles in their marriages, battles at their places of work, battles in their businesses, battles in their neighborhood, battles for their families, battles from household wickedness. Right now, my Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray, O God, Father, fight for them. Lord, help these your daughters. Help these your sons. Fight for them. Fight for them. Against every Goliath. Against every king of Assyria that is standing against their life. My Father, fight for them. Fight for them in Jesus' name. I hand over their battles to you by the power in the name of Jesus. My Father, I hand these battles. Oh, please, we are daughters and sons unto you right now. In the name of Jesus, Father, fight for them. Fight for them. In the name of Jesus, may this battle cease. In the name of Jesus Christ, let this battle cease. In the name of Jesus Christ, my Father, help them and fight for them. Help them and fight for them. Give them victory in Jesus' name. Give them victory in Jesus' name. Cause them to conquer every Goliath in their lives in Jesus' name. To conquer every king of Assyria in their lives in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I thank you because it is done. As you go back, I declare to you, you are conquering that Goliath in Jesus' name. Because God has taken over your battle. He is fighting for you. You will not see that king of Assyria again. You will not see that Goliath again. That Egyptian you have been seeing, you will not see them again. For the Lord has taken over your battle. He has fought for you. Thank you, Father. It is done. In Jesus' name we are praying. Amen. God bless you. The battle is over. God has taken over. You will testify in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. Now before we wind up, we cannot fail to pray for this church. Because this is where we get our spiritual nourishment. We have to stand in the gap for Dominion Worship Church. Because this is our camp of nourishment. Say, my Father, my Father. In the name of Jesus. Every battle that is being lifted against Dominion by Goliath. By the king of Assyria, Zadkiel, Lord, we pray in Jesus' name. As a church, fight for us, fight for dominion, fight for this church, fight for this ministry. Begin to pray. Father, fight for dominion, fight for this church, fight for this ministry. We hand over the battles. Let that be rising up against dominion from Goliath, from Zadkiel. From the king of Assyria, every battle that is raising up against this church, my Father, we pray, fight for this church, fight for us, fight for this ministry, fight for the ministry of church, the battles that are raising up against the ministry of church, my Father, we pray, fight for us as a church, fight for this ministry, fight for dominion, fight for this church, fight for this ministry, fight for this church, fight for the dominion, my Father, in our dreams, in our visions, in our projects, in our dreams. My Father, fight for us. Fight for us, O Lord. As a church, we are asking in Jesus' name. Fight for us, O Lord. 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 Fight for us as a church. In the name of Jesus, we hand over the battles of dominion unto you, my Father. Fight for us. Against every Goliath, against Zadkiel, the king of Assyria, fight for us as a church. Against Zadkiel, the king of Assyria, fight for us as a church. Fight for us as a ministry. My Father, fight for us in the name of Jesus. Fight for us, O Lord. Fight for this church. Fight for this ministry. Fight for this church. Fight for dominion. Fight for our dreams. Fight for our projects. Fight for our dreams. Say, my Father, my Father, in the name of Jesus, we ask you, O Lord, to fight for the Bishop Bela, Bishop Johnson Makoha, to fight fight for my reverend grace and their family in this season. Every battle that Goliath and Sennacherib rising up against them, have a fight for your servant. Make that prayer in Jesus' name. Fight for your servant, Bishop Johnson McCall. Fight for Reverend Grace Bell. Fight for the mission there. Fight for their family. Fight for their children. Every battle that Goliath is raising up against them, my father, fight for them. Fight for your servant. Fight for him, O God. In the name of Jesus, my father, fight for him. My God, fight for him. My father, fight for him. My God, fight for him. My father, fight for him. My God, fight for your servant, Bishop Johnson McGuire. Fight for your servant, Reverend Grace Mayo. Fight, my father, for their children in this season. Fight for our pastors. Fight for our leaders. Fight for the members of Dominion. Fight for the members of the mayor. Fight for your servant, Bishop Johnson McGuire. Fight for him, O God. In the name of Jesus, every battle that he is facing, we pray that we fight for him. Every battle that your servants are facing, my father, fight for them. In the name of Jesus, fight for your servants, my father. Fight for your servants, my God. In the name of Jesus, my father, fight for your servants. Fight for them in Jesus' name. Fight for your servants, O God. My father, fight for your servants. In the name of Jesus, my God, fight for your servants. My God, fight for the nation of man. Fight for his family. Fight for him, O God. In the mighty name of Jesus, my father, fight for him. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you because you have done it. Thank you for the message. And thank you, Father, for your servant, Pastor Gitao. We pray that you anoint him more, bless him and use him more, and bless his family in the name of Jesus. We worship you and glorify your name because it is done. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Shall we shout amen? In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You can kindly take your seats as we prepare to give and leave. Thank you, Pastor Kitao, for those that powerful message. I didn't know that you read something similar with what I read in the morning when I was leading prayer, because we had not discussed. And that is the working of the Holy Spirit of God. And the Holy Spirit of God is in our midst. Dominion is not a dead church. Dominion is a living church, where the Holy Spirit of God is present. And so he speaks to us in various ways. And that is the message he wanted us to hear. That is why I found myself reading it in the morning. I laid a prayer concerning a similar thing. And the man of God preached. Because the Holy Spirit is present in our midst. Can we all say amen? Can we all say amen? Amen. Before we give our offerings, and before I welcome our dear mom, Reverend Grace, to greet us and pray for us, I have few notices to give. And number one, want to congratulate all the KCPE candidates from this church because they all performed well. Shall we celebrate them? All of them passed examination. Shall we celebrate our children? We want you to know that we celebrate you and we love you and have been praying for you. And since it is Mama who has been praying for you and leading us into praying for you, I want to request her to come and speak a blessing, even as we prepare to go to those very, very serious schools. And in a few, when are you joining Form 1? In July. So I want her to speak a blessing to you, and as we celebrate your performance. We also have some teachers in our ministry. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Let us all stand.
Wacha tusimame.
As we thank God because of the excellence.
Tushukuru Bwana kwa sababu ya ubora wake.
Alipatia watoto wetu. Let's pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you because of this morning.
Shukuru kwa sababu ya siku ya leo.
Thank you because of your faithfulness, oh God.
Kwa sababu ya uaminifu wako.
Thank you for being with us, oh Jehovah God, in this
service.
We appreciate you, Jehovah God,
shukuru.
Because of our children who are here. Those who are not here, oh Jehovah God, they have completed the exams, oh my God, and the results came, oh Jehovah God. Thank you, Father, because of what you did unto them. Thank you, Father, for the excellence you have given unto them, Father. We've been praying for them, O Jehovah God, and you have seen the results of our prayers. We give you glory and honor, O God, because you are the Lord who have done it for them. It is not because of their effort, their knowledge, and their intelligence. Lord, it is because you've been with them. We know that Jehovah God, who has done this, oh God, will continue to be with them, oh God. In the next level of education, may you be with them, oh God. We celebrate their victory.
We are very proud of you. Very proud of you. Because our confidence was in God. Even when you were doing that exam, our confidence was in God.
As we give and go. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you because of this time, Lord. We appreciate you, Jehovah God, because of your faithfulness, O God. We lift your name on high. We magnify you, O God. Thank you because of your God that you have given unto us today. Through your servant, O God, may you continue to bless them. Bless his family. Watch over them, O God. Continue to watch over the delivered money. We thank you because you are in corruption. As we give our offering, as we pay the tithe, Lord, we pray.
Myself, to my family and those who are, I am there.
I am not the chain. I am above only. I am not beneath. I am not. Whatever I lay my hands on shall prosper. So shall it be in my life. Amen. Tithe confession. This is my tithe. A tenth of my increase. Father, I give it to you in the honor of your word. You have said, when I do this, you will open the windows of heaven for me. You rebuke the devourer on my behalf. And I believe this word is working for me. Amen. Let it work for you. And especially this week. God bless you. Amen.